And then come onto your hands and knees, facing forwards on your mat. And you're going to line the shoulders above the wrists. And the hips are above the knees. Have your feet flat on the floor. And spread your fingers wide. Make sure your index fingers are pointing forwards. And keep your abdominals lifted into the back. Then we're going to start tipping the tailbone up to the sky. Extend your chest bone forwards, look forwards. And then the other way, rounding the back, turning the tailbone down to the floor, lifting up through the shoulder blades, looking between your knees. Then moving back the other way, tipping your tailbone up to the sky, looking forwards. And the other way, slowly, slowly. We're going to do that two more times. Tipping the tailbone up, looking forwards. Keep the arms straight the whole time, making sure not to lock your elbows. Lift the belly. Last time, last round, looking forwards. And then one more time, round in the back. Come to what we call a neutral spine. So you're not arching and you're not rounding. Keep the abdominals lifted into the back. And this is the starting point for downward dog often. So we're going to move into practicing downward dog. You might have heard of that. It's very commonly used in yoga classes. So tuck your toes under and keep the hands pressed into the ground. Move your shoulders back, move your chest back towards your hips and your hips move back towards your heels. From here, you're going to press your hands into the floor. Keep your shoulders moving back. Lift the knees, lift the hips, and start to straighten the legs slightly. We still want bent knees. Press the palms of your hands into the ground and the finger pads into the ground. Lift up into the arms. So you want to try and get that sense of the arms becoming longer, all the way up from the wrist, up through the elbows, up into the armpits. Lifting up into the inner groins. As you move the tops of your thighs back and up towards the top of the wall behind you. Keep your belly lifted into the back. You don't want to let your belly be flopping out. And then take the knees to the ground. That was your first downward dog. Untuck your toes. Keep the hands where they are. Move your shoulders and chest back. Coming into what we call child's pose. So if this is as far as you can go without getting the head to the floor, that's fine. You can get your block and place your forehead on a block. If you can easily get your head to the floor, that's fine too. You may or may not want to take your knees wider depending on how it feels for you. So try to keep the elbows lifted off the ground. And then we're going to come back up again. Bring the knees underneath the hips. Tuck your toes. Lift the knees. Move the hips up and back. Into downward dog again. So this is a little short downward dog practice with a couple of other poses to introduce you to some key postures that you are likely to do if you join a public class or if you continue to practice with me. Now we're going to walk the hands backwards towards your feet. Stay folded in half. Make sure your big toes are pointing forwards and let your belly fold down towards your thighs. Bend your knees as much as you need in order to do that. Let the head relax. And it might be more comfortable for you to take an elbow in each hand and let the arms hang. Press your feet down into the ground. Lifting up into the inner groins. Let the back relax. Now take your hands to the floor. Walk your hands forward again, back to downward dog as we were. As you walk the hands forward, keep your abdominals lifted so you're using your core. And then you're going to press the hands into the floor. lifting up into the tops of the thighs, spreading your toes, spreading your fingers. Take your knees to the floor. Take your knees slightly wider with the big toes touching. Come to another child's pose. Keep the elbows lifted off the ground so you get a still a nice long lengthening, extending sensation along the spine. Coming back up, bring your knees under. And we're going to do one more downward dog, tucking the toes, lift the knees, lift the hips. So you want to have this idea of pressing the palms of your hands, the whole of the palm on both hands into the ground, like you're trying to move the mat away from you forwards. And bring your weight forwards into the finger pads as well, so it's not all in the wrists. So press the fingers into the ground as well. And then lift up through the inner ankles, inner knees, inner thighs, into the groins. At the same time, you're spreading your toes and your weight is on the balls of the feet, not the toes. So obviously your toes are on the ground, but the weight is more about being spread evenly through the balls of your feet. And it doesn't matter if your heels are off the ground. And let's take the knees to the floor, untuck the toes, one last child's pose, come all the way down. Take a couple of deep breaths. Come back up to hands and knees. Fold your one shin over the other behind you, walk your hands back. And then sit down onto the ground behind your feet. And if you have a block or a book or a cushion, you're going to sit on your block. Cross your shins. Take your hands either side of you. And let's take the right hand to the floor. Reach the left arm up overhead. Stretching along the left side of your body. Coming back to the center, take the left hand to the floor, bring the right arm up, stretching along the right side of your body. Come back to the center. Bring your hands together into this position. It's called prayer position, quite often in yoga classes. There are other names for it, but it often gets called prayer position. So the palms touch, fingers touch, and you're going to rest the thumbs against the centre of your chest. Draw the belly in, sitting upright, and relax the shoulders, relax the neck and the face. Breathing smoothly through the nose, closing the eyes perhaps. Bowing your forehead towards your thumbs. Namaste.